Hello everyone, so 2 days ago I was checking my Instagram account and I was checking my photos, searching for an interesting subject to talk about today. Maybe a challenge that I faced during taking the photo, maybe a challenge in the post-processing of the photo, and I came across these two photos. And I started, after I saw these photos, I started to ask myself why I haven't made any black and white photos since something like 1 year. Because I like this type a lot of photography, black and white photography, especially when in nature, because I'm interested in landscape photography and in woodland photography. So I started to ask myself why I haven't made something like that since 1 year. And especially in foggy days, when there's a lot of fog, I like to make black and white photos. You know, in foggy days, you can have that moody, black, scary black and white photo. I selected three photos from my old photos. Two of them I made 1 year ago, and one of them I made something like 4 months ago, last January. The three photos were made in the morning during foggy days, so I will try to approach that moody and dark black and white photos. So let's play the intro and I will come back to you. So that was like a small intro I made for my channel. I hope you like it, and if you don't, tell me in the comments. So let's go to Lightroom and to start with the editing. So as you can see, here is the three photos. I have six photos because I have, this is the first one, the raw file, and this is after editing. The second one, I have here the raw file, and this is after editing. The third one here, I have this photo here after editing, and this is the raw file. And as you can see, there's no contrast at all in this photo because I took it at the early morning, and it was there was a lot of fog, and I took it at 195 millimeter, which means there's a lot of fog compressed in this photo, and that's why there's no contrast at all. So I will start with the first photo. And as you can see, there's also a lot of fog. So I will start by changing it to black and white directly by clicking here. So as you can see, there's no contrast at all, and I have to do a lot of things. So first of all, in black and white photos, I think the most important thing is that you have to give a lot of contrast. So I will start by doing something like that. And let me see the highlights. I will not take it off. Maybe something like that. And of course, I will not open the shadow because it will make it so flat. So something like that. And after that, I will bring up the white. But I have to be careful because I don't want the information of the small branch here of the tree, I don't want them to disappear. That's why I will be careful with whites. Okay, I will try to take off the highlights and to give more whites, something like that. So with the black, I will give also black to even give more contrast to the photo. Let me try to make it 4x5 because I don't like here the beginning of the ground, so distracting. Maybe something like that. No, I don't want to cut the branch here. So let me try something like, I don't want to cut the branch also here. If I want to make it 2/3 to the tree and 1/3 to the ground, I will cut the branch here, and I don't want that. So let me go up a little bit, something like that. So now I will give more clarity so the information of the tree will show up more, something like that. Okay, so now the tanker, this is the most important place to play with if you want to achieve that moody and dark black and white photos. Because in these situations, foggy days and black and white photos, I like to have a lot of fade in my photos. This is my opinion, and this is what I like. There's a lot of people don't like to make fade in black and white photos, but I like that in foggy days and when you want to achieve that moody and scary black and white photos, I like to have a lot of fade. So I will come to medium contrast. I will take off this point here because I don't want to have a lot of heavy contrast in the shadow. So I will try to bring it up a little bit, something like that. So as you can see, this is the without, there's no fade at all, and this is the after. And I really love this fade. Even in my woodland photos and landscape photos without black and white, I always try to give a little bit of fade, not too much, but in black and white photos I like to give too much fade. So let me say something like that, and I will do the same to the highlights. So this is before and after, before, after. As you can see, even the highlights here have a little bit of fade. And after that I will come to black and white mix, and it doesn't play any role actually in this photo because there's not a lot of color. I have only the green here, and it's not that vibrant green. So if I want to play with the green, maybe I will not take it like that. Maybe I will bring it back something like that. Not overdo it. Something like that. So now I have the split toning. As you know, split toning is giving color to the highlights and to the shadow. Even if I have right now black and white photo, I still can give specific color to the highlight and a specific color to the shadow. I don't actually prefer this method a lot in black and white photos, because when I have a black and white photo, I like it to stay in black and white. For example, let me show you, if I want to give yellow to the highlights, and if I want to give a blue to the shadows. So as you can see, I started to have colors in the photo more than black and white itself, and that's why I don't prefer this method a lot in black and white photos. But as you know, obviously this is something personal. If you like, for example, to give yellow color to highlights or any other color, you can do that with split toning. But for me, I don't like it in black and white photos. So let me turn that off and come back to the sharpening. I will give, let me put the sharpening something like 70, and I will make a mask. So if I didn't change the mask, all the photo will be in sharp, even the white areas here. And that's why I will click the Alt key, and now the sharpening is affecting only the white areas, and the black areas will stay without any sharpening. And noise reduction, I will add only something like 20 because I have a little bit of noise. I will enable profile correction, and I will remove chromatic aberration. So after that, I will add just a little bit of post crop fin tag, and the midpoint I will bring it to the middle, something like that, so it will not be so hard. And the feather also I will, so as you can see, it's not so strong. Let me go back to 9, yeah, something like that. So let me go back to the turn curve. I will try to add even more contrast. So I'll try to bring up the highlights a little bit to make this area here even more interesting, where the fog and where is the main subject of the photo. Maybe more contrast, just a little bit of more contrast. Let me just select the brush, and after that select lighten or dodge, and try to paint only the road here to make it more visible, something like that. I will add exposure and contrast. So this is the before, after, before, after. Not too much. Maybe I will go back with the exposure. So I think I am done with the first photo. As you can see, we could achieve that scary and moody, foggy, black and white photos. I will not spend a lot of time like the first photo because now you have the main idea. So as I said at the beginning, this is something personal. Maybe some of you don't like to add fade to the black and white photos or to the shadow areas, for example, in black and white photos. I feel when I add a lot of fade to the photo, I make it more mysterious, and this is what I like about black and white nature foggy days. I like it to be so mysterious, and because of the fog, obviously, when you have fog and you want to make the photo black and white, you feel that when you make it more mysterious because of the fog, it's more interesting. So at the end, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful. Please consider subscribing if you are not already, and see you in the next video. Bye.